What we should focus on in the first instance is renovating the buildings that exist today. Now, if in the instance you can't, for whatever reason, renovate a building, and there will be reasons that you need to construct new buildings, when we demolish those buildings, actually reuse the material.
Who gets to decide what gets built, when it gets built, how it gets built? Currently, apart from a handful of people in architectural offices or planning offices, most people do not have agency in deciding any of this, despite the fact that cities and buildings affect our lives deeply.
We haven't managed to break that symbiotic relationship between economic growth and emissions. City governments should be setting really strong standards that push developers to be using the lowest carbon possible materials. Mayors should always be setting standards that are somewhat ahead of where the market is telling them that they are ready to move.
I think density of cities is one of the biggest stumbling blocks to achieve any of the sustainable development goals. Throughout the 20th century, the global cities of the world have actually declined in density significantly. That means that there is more consumption of resource because sparse cities consume more transport costs, more heating costs. The more we can densify cities, the more closer we can be to net zero.
A circular building obviously has to start with the materials from which it has been constructed, looking right back through the supply chain of every component that's gone into that building and ensuring that each decision along the way, the carbon emissions have been minimized and every product that can be reused has been reused rather than buying new.
About 85% of the buildings in the UK that will exist in 2050 are already built. London today, phenomenal buildings that have been here with us for 500 years, 1,000 years. Keeping them relevant, refurbing them, keeping them adequate for our needs, I think is a different aspect of circularity.